Hello, and today we will put forward two pretty cool things we saw at the EPG trade fair. And yes, I know I'm a bit biased because of my love for video and nice imagery, but I think you will probably find this report not only interesting but also quite spectacular. Well, at least I did. Actually, I felt like a little kid in a candy store with this.
So can you explain us a little bit the technology that you're presenting here at this EPHG?
Yes. We are Hirox, the inventor of video microscopy, and we have the latest 3D digital microscope to look at watches from a different perspective. Instead of having a traditional 2D view with simple measurements, we have the whole range of magnification as well as a special feature that I will show you, which is 3D rotary heads enabling 360 degree rotation around an object to look, for example, inside a movement. The goal is to find the point of interest and really focus on it. If it's for quality control or for research and development, for different material, for different parts, it's a very overall product for the entire inspection and measurement system.
And initially, for what industry was this technology developed?
Well, Hirox started in 1985 to produce optics for video microscopy, so to look at an object bigger on a screen. And our first customer were very much in semiconductor technology as well as microelectronics. We sold many systems to Apple computers or Nokia, Intel, and so on.
Well, now let's have fun and let's go for a demo.
Okay. So right now we put a lens with a magnification from 20 up to 160 times. We have the possibility to tilt the level of inspection, and on top of tilting the stand, we have a system of rotational mirror, as I was explaining before, which allows a motorized rotation to look at hidden places. For example, right now we can see inside the movements and look at specific details that are usually very hard to reach. Right now we could see a little impurity inside the movements. This is something that we can document. I can at any time just freeze the image, zoom onto the surface, click to a specific location, and here for example we have 33 micron. This I can capture it, and then I can maybe look at the same object with different angle or different magnification. All the optics are calibrated, so you always see the correct scale, and you can also use this to do any kind of measurements. Here we have a controller that has allows wireless movement and control of the motorized X, Y, and Z table. I can then look at a different space, and we have a completely new way to look at a movement in this case, but this can be done also for any specific part of the watch. In this case it really creates a three-dimensional effect. It's like flying inside the movements, which is very unique, and we are not sure what it is. Is it on top of a surface? Is it inside a surface? Yeah. When you start rotating, you can clearly see that it's this one is actually a scratch.
Yeah.
You can see a scratch, and you can see some material moving up and down on both sides. Right now we are using a diffuser adapter with a straight view, so you see we have completely different view. It's very two-dimensional, very flat. Now the system combines all the single steps to generate one image where everything is in focus. Mm-hmm. This is a common problem when you are in high magnification. Mm-hmm. You only have a small depth of field. Yeah. Now everything is in focus, and then I can just open here in a 3D view, and then directly we can do a measurement here with a profile to see, for example, the height of the component. So right now I'm at a quite small magnification, so you don't have the same level as if I go to 1,000 time or even 10,000 time, which is the maximum we can zoom in. Up to 10,000 time, yes. So it's very simple to change the lens.
That looks like a serious lens.
Yes, it is indeed. So I can just connect it here and then mount it. Okay, now we are at 700 time. And now let's go to 1,000, even 2,000 times. Now the system, while it's moving, is acquiring a series of images. Here it's already done. You can open it in 3D. Here show the pseudo color, which shows the height. And you see the scratch. You can see the direction of the scratch, the material that has been stretched here. And just go to the profile measurements. And here we have between this level here and this level, 2.6 micron.
Well, I guess unfortunately it can be perhaps sometimes embarrassing for some of the watchmakers to see some of those treatments.
I have to say I'm extremely impressed by the quality of Swiss watches, and the big names have excellence, beautiful, smooth surfaces. But it's a very common thing that I hear is, we see too many detail, we see too much. And but there is a trend also to go to the limits of the possibilities, to have movements and parts that are so perfect that there is, you can use it for 200 years, 500 years, and you know that with this level of quality, it's really a long-lasting investment. We work also with Formula One, with aerospace, and we are definitely in the same level of research for the perfection, which I really appreciate.
That's interesting. Yeah.
Yes. Excellent. Very impressed.
So I think I'm going to go for the ultimate test with a little baby here.
Wow.
So well made. I mean, you really feel that you've been doing this for quite a while. I mean, it feels pretty mature.
So the second thing we saw came from Leica, and though it is a bit more difficult to picture, well, we got to experience a really cool binocular. Until then, all binoculars used the same lenses for both of your eyes, but now with this new development, you get kind of a 3D effect with this stereoscopic approach that mixes high resolution for one lens and the other one working on depth of field. So each lens focuses on these two separate tasks, and it's actually your brain that combines both imagery into a more realistic perception of what you are looking at. Well, this is naturally super relevant in watchmaking, and furthermore for artisans that are working on such minute components. For instance, while we were there and discovering this new binocular, we got to meet up with, and by chance, with a guy we had previously done a report with when he was working for Gégère Lecoultre as a micropainter. He has now changed employer and works for the fantastic atelier of Olivier Vaucher. We also had done a very interesting report on this small Geneva workshop. I clearly invite you to see this one if not yet done, and all links below in the description box. And well, it was super interesting to see his reaction when he was actually testing this binocular. For him, this new tool represented a serious alternative which would ease his job, because the imagery your brain creates actually makes it much more comfortable and natural to look at, especially when you're working 8 hours a day with your eyes stuck on such a binocular. So with regular binoculars, you see things very precisely, of course, but everything seems more flat. It's actually your brain that has to compensate to get this sense of depth of field, which is naturally needed to adjust where you place your paintbrush, and we're talking fractions of a millimeters in some cases. So this new binocular can really help you for these kinds of situations or needs, and will ease the work of these artisans whose brain can now concentrate more on their artistic craft. I naturally tested this extensively, and yes, that would be yet another cool item to find under the Christmas tree. And there are two versions of this binocular existing, one with simple eye vision, and the second one you can actually record what you see and also transfer this on a large screen with a really good image quality. Well, we can trust Leica on this one. So this is it for this special imagery report. I just wanted to share something different for you guys. All the best, and see you real soon.